goodbye. If we do not meet again on earth, we shall surely reassemble at his feet in heaven. I'll try, with God's help, to bring to the people of Hawaii the blessings that I've enjoyed here on this farm with you.
God's work is waiting, children.
Gold thimble in your sewing kit.
Oh, Charity, don't be sad.
Keoki will continue his instructions in the Hawaiian language.
What has led you to this decision?
You, mostly. I've seen more than one man lost doubling the Cape. I don't want to go like them. Neither does Cridland here.
You will receive your Bibles. Both of you. The Lord has spoken. And you have listened.
Bound for Baltimore.
Round of the Horn in 3 days with a gale at her back. Captain says in our place he'd head for Africa and the Cape of Good Hope.
I'll not have it entered in the log of this ship that I ran away from the Horn. We turn north and try for the Strait of Magellan. Mr. Collins, up anchor.
Aye, sir.
They're bananas, Reverend. You better start getting to like them. They're the basic food of the islands.
Bananas?
Dutchmen and Spaniards have done it. Some of our own whalers have managed to get through.
Why is it so difficult?
It isn't until the end. See those rocks, the four evangelists. The westerlies from the Pacific pile up tremendous waves all the way along the exit from the passage. In trying to break out, they throw you on to the evangels.
Worse than the Horn?
Aye, they are, but the difference is this. If you try to double the Horn under these conditions, you'd have 50 days of mountainous seas, which would break you up sooner or later. This way, you can breast them in an afternoon, if you're lucky and the evangels don't grab you.
Please, no, dear husband. It's the smell of oil I don't like.
It doesn't matter whether we like it or not. They are nourishing. Mm. They were sent us to be used. Otherwise, God would not have put them aboard this ship. No,
please don't make me eat them. Please don't.
That's delicious.
I'm going to be sick. I'm going to be sick.
No, Mrs. Hale, you may not be sick.
Oh. I can't stand it.
Before my people did away with the kapus, it was forbidden by the gods for women to eat bananas.
But what do you want?
I thought you should know that the old sailor you gave the Bible to, he brought more from the other ship than bananas.
Laughing at poor old men. First man says I'm drunk. My God, I'll...
Oh, no. Oh, don't take my Bible. Oh, please don't take my Bible, Reverend. Don't do that to me! Don't, Reverend. Don't take it away from me. Please, I'm afraid. Reverend, please don't take it away from me. Don't leave me without it, Reverend.
Will we be in smooth water long, Captain Janders?
Unhappily, no.
Oh, dear.
There's nothing to fear. He who made this Strait of Magellan can conduct us through it safely.
May I count on your prayers, Reverend Hale, as we attempt the evangelist?
Are you prepared to throw your profane novels overboard and run a Christian ship?
If the Almighty can be bribed, I'll pay his price. Books are cheaper than ships.
I'll tell you frankly, Reverend Hale, there have been moments on this voyage when I thought you a considerable nuisance. I was wrong. I'm glad to have you aboard. Apparently, I'm not the only one that's lightening the ship this evening.
Mrs. Hale!
My name is Jerusha. You bullied me, Abner. You bullied me through the sin of your pride. Never again will I submit to your bullying. I am as good a judge of God's will as you. And God never intended that a woman as sick as I should eat so hatefully.
Reverend Hale. Reverend Hale, can I have my Bible back now?
You may not.
Abner, he saved the ship.
I prayed for you while you were aloft. And I pray for you now. But never again will I accept a man of uncertain faith into the community of Christ.
Then I'll give you my Bible, Mr. Mason.
Thank you, ma'am.
Sided with him. How?
God has no meaning to me, Abner, unless he's willing to reveal himself, even to an evil man, with love.
He's an unregenerate backslider, and always will be.
Perhaps.
One backslider can bring more shame upon the church than a dozen unredeemed sinners.
Mm-hmm.
Are you sleepy? Brother Hewlett, what happened?
She was near her time, and we thought Brother Whipple might be here in Lahaina, so we decided to come from Wailuku in canoes, but the seas were heavy and we were washed ashore at Kahulavi. She died there in the woods, but giving birth. But for Malia, the baby would be dead too.
My dear Brother Hewlett.
Oh, here. Put this around it.
John Whipple is here or not. You will not die, Jerusha, and neither will our child. Tomorrow, and every day until the baby comes, we will practice all the emergencies of childbirth and how to overcome them. In many ways, I'm wanting, but I have memorized the book. I know everything that must be done. I will do them. And you will live, Jerusha.
Coming now.
Scream if you want to, but you must help me.
Expect a fever to go even higher. After that, food and rest. Don't worry, you'll be all right. He has the constitution of a workhorse.
Thank you, John.
Dear child, I failed you, Iliki. I failed to impress on you and your punishment. Oh, dear God, no, no, no. Your soul, Iliki,
Your soul.
Did you find him changed?
Not as much as I. You have a fever. You shouldn't talk.
I sinned when I took you. I sin this day in keeping you. I cannot love both you and God.
God is spirit. I'm flesh. God is to be worshipped. A wife needs only to be loved. Sleep.
Come what may, I shall put it as a motion from the floor that we petition the king to prohibit the sale of land to non-Hawaiians.
What would the ultimate purpose of such a law be?
These lands were given by God to the Hawaiian people as their birthright. If they continue to pass into the possession of foreigners, the kingdom is doomed.
Our instructions forbid us to meddle in governmental affairs, and I, for one, intend to obey them.
I trust, Brother Quigley, this means not availing yourself personally of land which those same instructions forbid us to acquire.
Brother Whipple?
Brother Abner?
You have brought shame upon our church by your part in this, Brother John.
I am sorry you take that view.
It is not my view, it's the Bible's. Consult Ezekiel 23:30. Thou hast gone a-whoring after the heathen.
If there be no further discussion, we shall now vote on that resolution calling for the expulsion of Brother Abraham Hewlett from his ministry.
Because Nualani and Keoki lusted like rutting beasts in the field before your very eyes, because they broke the commandments of God and the laws of man. Now has God punished them, as Isaiah foretold. Howl ye, for the day of the Lord is at hand, cruel, both with wrath and fierce anger, and he shall destroy the sinners thereof out of the land, and they shall be afraid. They shall be in pain as a woman that travaileth. Pangs and sorrows shall take hold of them. Behold, for the day of the Lord cometh as a destruction from the Almighty. I hear some saying this and some saying that, and some weeping. But to all of you I say, take heed before it is too late. Take warning, for the deformed offspring of that evil union was ordained by Almighty God himself, who has said, I will punish the wicked for their iniquity. The wild beasts of the islands shall cry out in their desolate houses, and dragons in their pleasant palaces. Everyone that is found shall be thrust through. Their houses shall be spoiled, their wives ravished. Their children also shall be dashed to pieces before their eyes. Mrs. Hale!
What you prayed for has come to pass. The child is dead. Keoki has drowned it.
Mm-hmm.
thank you.
Right over here, Reverend Quigley.
In your travels, have you come across a little Hawaiian girl named Iliki?
Nope.
You see, she was stolen from this port some time ago, and I'm deeply concerned for her salvation.
Sorry, Reverend.
Father!
Yeah?
Reverend Quigley's here.
Why, it's Brother Quigley.